Omid Scobie, the co-author of Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's biography Finding Freedom, hinted that he is blocking people on Twitter. Taking to the microblogging website, he wrote, "Normalize blocking just for the vibes," without sharing the reason behind his decision. His tweet came after some royal family fans started trolling over his interview in BBC documentary The Princes and the Press. Several British royal experts took to social media to criticize him. A senior journalist associated with Daily Mail called him cheerleader of Meghan Markle. A royal fan said he was included in the documentary to plead innocence for the Duchess of Sussex. Without responding to criticism, Omid wrote on Twitter, "For full transparency, the interview I gave for BBC's The Princes and the Press took place on November 19, 2020. The British royal family slammed the BBC over a documentary that claimed a behind-the-scenes briefing war erupted before Prince Harry and his wife Meghan quit frontline duties. The Princes and the Press dwelt on how Harry and his elder brother William have handled the media as they rose to adult prominence following the tragic death of their mother Diana in 1997. While commenting on new documentary, Daily Mail diary editor Richard Eden on Tuesday said that the broadcaster allowed Meghan Markle's cheerleader Omid Scobie to spread misinformation. Taking to social media, he said the BBC contradicted the evidence on its programme. His comments come after hundreds of royal fans accused the BBC of including Scobie, the co-author of Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's biography Finding Freedom, to plead the Duchess of Sussex's innocence. Omid Scobie, who was trolled on Twitter, said, "For full transparency, the interview I gave for BBC's The Princes and the Press took place on November 19, 2020. Britain's royal family has slammed the BBC over a documentary that claimed a behind-the-scenes briefing war erupted before Prince Harry and his wife Meghan quit frontline duties. The Princes and the Press dwelt on how Harry and his elder brother William have handled the media as they rose to adult prominence following the tragic death of their mother Diana in 1997. The first of two episodes, which aired on Monday night, suggested that Harry in particular had a hostile attitude to the media, which worsened after he started dating US actress Meghan Markle in 2016. The program claimed palace insiders drip-fed the media with negative stories about the initially popular Harry and Meghan, as a power battle played out behind palace walls. But it also reported that Harry sabotaged positive press coverage of a Middle East tour by his father Prince Charles, when he issued a blistering statement defending Meghan against unfavorable headlines. "A free, responsible and open press is of vital importance to a healthy democracy," said a joint statement by the three royal households representing Queen Elizabeth II, Charles and William, which was included in the programme. However, too often it is overblown and unfounded claims from unnamed sources that are presented as facts, and it is disappointing when anyone, including the BBC, gives them credibility. The royal family could boycott the national broadcaster in future, reports said. "Nothing is ruled out," the Sun newspaper reported, citing a senior royal source. Royal expert Duncan Larcombe questioned why Meghan Markle and Prince Harry continue to use their royal titles during their public engagements when they are no longer working royals. He warned against the wrong message it could give, especially to those who have been critical of their decisions ever since they stepped back as senior royals. He called it dangerous since people would start asking about their motives and this could negatively affect the reputation of the British royals. "The fact she and Harry are still using their titles is dangerous because people will start to ask, they are royals, but what are they doing all this for? For good, or for their own gain?" Larcombe told that.